art friends, welcome back. So we are going to draw an animal and implement the patterns that we just learned to use. Today we're gonna do a cow. We are gonna start with an oval. And then above that oval, we're gonna draw half of a circle. We're gonna copy that again, going just outside our line. So you're copying the same line you already made, but just going a little bit outside of it. And here, for our eyes, we're gonna do two circles. What I like to do is put a tiny circle in each and color around it so it's like a little light spot. And it gives it like a nice little cartoon effect to it. And then we give some little eyebrows. We're gonna do just a slightly curved line above each eye. For the nose, again, we will draw circles, but this time we're gonna close them. And then we will draw a curved line going towards the side on each side, so it'll look basically like a comma. And now we have our little cow nostrils. We're gonna do horns above. So we're gonna do a curved line. We're gonna round it instead of point it because it's a friendly cow. And then we're just gonna follow the line we've already made to come back to the head. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So we're mirroring the image. So we're curving in again, and then we're rounding it out, and then just going back to the start. And that's our little cow horns. For the ears, we'll start just a little bit up on the horn, and we're gonna do a circle coming in and down on the head. We'll do that on each side, again, mirroring it. We know we can do it because we did it once before. And then inside, we will just follow the line that we've already made here and do a smaller version on the inside. So now we've got our cute little cow head. We're gonna go onto the body. We're gonna make a sitting cow. So we're gonna do a curved line and go out a little bit larger on each side of the nose. We're gonna curve in a little bit more on each side. And then we're gonna draw the front legs. So we're gonna do like a rectangle that's rounded, and we're just not gonna close it. So we're gonna leave it open on this side. We're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Long line down, rounding it out, and then coming up to meet our other line that we made. So now we're going to do the tummy. What I like to do to estimate the lines that I don't want to go through is I just draw a little bit higher than the page, and then that shows me exactly where I need to be. On each side, we're going to do a line out and a line out. And just like we did on these legs, we're gonna curve in, curve in, and then we're just coming up to meet the side. And then for the hooves, we're just gonna draw a line across each about an inch from the bottom. Put the tail of the cow right here, and we're just gonna do a wavy line, and then we're gonna curve it in and just follow that wavy line we already made, and we'll do it right from the end. So since we were learning prints, we will do those inside of our spots, so you can pick where you would like your spots to go, and they're just going to be kind of wavy, like when you crack an egg open on the pan, like a sunny side egg. So just nice big waves, They don't have to go in a particular spot. Some may want lots and lots of spots. Some of you may like just a few. You do what works best for you. Put a couple on top of this noggin. And we will turn him into a galaxy cow using the galaxy print we just learned how to do. I'll put the moon in here. And then we're gonna put a couple of dots around. And we'll do the dots in each spot. They can go wherever you like, however many you like. And then we'll do a couple of the twinkling stars, which is doing the plus sign with our X inside. We'll put a couple of those around, plus with an X, plus with an X. You don't have to put one in every single spot, just where you like. And then we'll do a couple of those open dots as well. I like to do a few going towards the edge to let you believe that the pattern goes further than what you can see. And because it's a galaxy cow, we will make a little planet off to the side. So we're gonna do a big circle. And my favorite planet is Saturn. So we'll start on the edge, make a little dot on each side where we want to start, and then we'll just do wavy lines to go across to meet our other dot. They can go in between and around each other on top, does not matter. You can just put as many as you like. And I like to put dots along the side just for some texture. And that is a little galaxy cow. And if you want to, since the cow jumps over the moon, you can have them taking a little rest on the moon and just put that right below. And so that's just doing a large half circle at the bottom of your page. And then you can put a couple of dots in, because those are always fun. And maybe some little craters, because it's a moon. Again, you don't have to do it, it's just if you feel like it. When you're coloring, if you have crowns at home, you can do what's called a gradient to make a really fun galaxy print. So I like to use blue, green, and yellow. And another fun one is using the same blue, a grape type purple, and one that's more violet, so it's got a little pink into it. To do a gradient, you're just blending the colors together. So you would start with your blue, and then you're gonna put your green next. But you'll go on top of the blue so that they're blending together and one doesn't just abruptly end. And then you can put your yellow on the bottom. So that's a fun galaxy type gradient. It's a word you can use and look super fancy in the art community. Just gonna add a color gradient. And again, we're gonna start with our blue, but this time we're gonna add that grape purple next. And again, we're gonna go up into our blue a little bit so that they're blended nicely together. And then we'll add our violet at the bottom. And we'll go up into our purple a little bit. So those are two fun little galaxy gradients you can use with either the blue, grape purple, and violet, or your blue, green, and yellow. And We have one that's all the way done that uses both of those right here. I hope you guys had fun and we will see you next time. Thank you.